What's going on, guys? River here. Welcome to another episode in our Legend of Zelda Let's Play series. I said it right this time. In this episode, we are going to get the last tier of light. For some reason, it didn't show up on our map until now, though. Seems kind of weird, but must just be something odd that happened. So it's right in the middle of the Lake Hylia, it seems. So we'll go ahead and warp there now. Talk to Midna, warp, and there we go. Good thing we got that warp zone there, at least. So let's go ahead and get this last tier and return back to human form. And then we can actually go see Leia and save Prince Ralis, maybe. Whoa. That doesn't look like one of the normal bugs we've been fighting. Guess we should go check it out. Whichever way it is. I guess this is the faster way right here. Right in the middle of the water. There's lightning too. Oh god. This can't be good. It looked pretty big. I don't see it. Maybe it's not here anymore? Let's go ahead and go over here. Oh man. Oh no. Here it comes. Oh no. Huh? There it is. So, yep. We use our senses to see it, and it is big. It is a bug, and it is disgusting. Man, this thing is ugly. Okay, so you can't use your thing to attack it, you just have to do jump attacks. Good to know. Just thought I'd try that out at first. But yeah, this thing's pretty disgusting. Just saying. And we get to just attack it, and it's disgusting. So once we do attack it, it goes underwater and starts running around trying to get us off into the water. But luckily we're smarter than that. Or are we? Nope! He tried to attack us, but we managed to save it. We just had to jump off for a second. Oh! He attacked us, now we can attack him again! Attack! Alright, I think we just got one more shot. Three is the lucky number. He's coming around. One more charge, I think. Here he comes. Nothing too extreme. So he's gonna jump at us one more time. And I actually ended up getting hitting from him. But I still attacked him, yes! So we attack him for the third time, and he'll end up falling to the ground. Into the water. We can climb on top of him, and use our epic attack, multi-attack, and get every single one of his little leg things. And he's down. Disgusting. But at least we got the tier of light. I wonder what Midna says. Hey, hurry up and pick up the tier of light that it dropped. Whoa! I picked it up, but it like didn't go da-da-da-da. Is it gonna... Okay. Aw, but I'm not blue. Man. Huh. I didn't know you could collect it if you talked to Midna first. That's kind of funny. The vessel of light is full of tears and light has returned to this area. Yay! I can still see him down there. We should go pick him back up and then take him. You make sure to get that last few shadow now. Hehehe, see you later. I wish I could do backflips and stuff like that. And the crown thing again. Here comes the light! What is it gonna look- Whoa! I thought I had more time to explain what it's gonna look like. It's a giant serpent thing. Man, that thing's big. You'd think it'd be like... It would like the entire Lake Hylia to swim in rather than this little area. But I mean, whatever. My name is Lenaru. Your efforts have at last restored each of us light spirits in Hyrule. O hero chosen by the gods, the dark power that you seek, it waits in a temple set in the bed of Lake Hylia. But before seeking it, you must now bear witness to something and never forget it. Okay, here we go. You must know that it was the will of the goddess that we lock away the forbidden power. Here we go. Here's some messed up stuff that's about to happen that I don't understand still. When all was chaos, the goddesses descended and gave order and life to the world.
Whee!
We're floating! They granted power equally to all who dwelt in the light and then returned to the heavens. Oh god, I better like... This is gonna sound really weird. Lands where the goddesses descended came to be known as the Sacred Realm. This gets really messed up. For ages, the people lived in at ease, content in mind and body. But soon, word of the Sacred Realm spread through Hell and a great battle ensued. Now she doesn't have pupils. Now she's gonna attack us, but I don't know what happened there. I guess we attacked her first. Yeah. I don't even... Then there's... these guys, among those living in the light, and interlopers who excelled at magic appeared. They look like us! Wielding powerful sorcery, they tried to establish dominion over the Sacred Realm. Oh, this is nice. No! Oof, we're dead. Or are we? Oh, it's so creepy. But then the light forces, yay! It was then that the goddesses ordered us three light spirits to intervene. We sealed away the great magic those individuals that had mastered. They're like, no! No! Who did that scream? I want to know the person who had to do that scream, because that is awesome. You know this magic. Yes, I do. It is the dark power you seek, the fused shadow. Ah, it's terrifying. Oh, not this part. Oh, hero chosen by the goddess, beware. This is so weird. Those who do not know the danger of wielding power will, before long, be ruled by it. Never forget that. What is this? Why am I smiling? It's over. It's over. It's terrifying. The dark power that you seek is within the sleeping lake bed temple in Lake Hylia. Okay. Yeah. So, that's that. We're just gonna pretend we know exactly what that guy's talking about and continue on with life as if that never happened. Don't think we can do anything here yet, so we'll just leave now. So, now we have to go to the lake bed where the next temple is. The problem is, we don't have any way of getting down there. So I guess we're gonna have to go save Prince Rallus to get that suit. Luckily that'll also mean that we get to see Leia in the process. I'm going the wrong way, ignore that. So we're gonna go ahead and go over to this castle thingy house place doohickey majigger with the guy Fire and Fobby's Flight Frenzy or something like that. You can actually climb that ladder now and go over to that howl statue thing, but we're not a wolf anymore, so it's pointless. We can't howl it anymore. But we do still have that other wolf to get to as well. There's a Zora! I'm a member of the Zora tribe, the proud people who care for Lake Hylia. And the other Zoras are all on guard patrol, at the bottom of the lake. We got this guy, if you were hearing closely enough, but we don't want to talk to that guy. He's a jerk. So, here's the old man again.
Herm, some of the Zoras are still alive down under there. I thought maybe they dried up along with the lake. Hey, buddy, have you heard? There's like a temple or something at the bottom of this lake. They put on such airs with all their rituals and fancy temple hoo-ha. They just disappeared. And what's with them putting that temple so deep that humans can't swim there? That's where the Zoras. Oh. Are you a customer? Yeah. You're one lucky fella. The height of excitement, the thrill of launching to the heavens, the very peak of flying fantastification. It could be yours, fella, for a limited time only, and without waiting in line. It's a paltry 10 rupees. What do you say, buddy of mine? Give me a shot.
Oh, sure. It's only 10 rupees. So we get to... I don't want to talk to you. I want to get in the cannon. We're going to soar to the sky, but not before listening to this awesome song. I would buy this on iTunes. Yeah. It's fun. We get to get shot out of a cannon. This looks safe, right? All that wobbling. Yep. He shoots us toward a house. Luckily, we managed to just kind of appear into the sky. And we're safe. Whoa, that reminds me of something. Didn't the late queen in Zora's domain ask you to do something? She asked you to find her son, the one who's been missing since she headed for Hyrule Castle. I think she said something about granting you some special power if you rescued him. Yes, I already mentioned that. If the final piece of your shadow is on the bottom of the lake, then it looks like you were going to have to need that ability. Couldn't agree more. Let's do some speedrunning here. We could climb down the ladder, but I'm gonna backflip off it. Yeah. So we're gonna do something here real quick. We're gonna talk to Fobby. Falby. Hello, hi there. Welcome to Falby's Flight of Bifal. Are you ready for your full flight full of dreams and sweet, sweet bonuses? A Cougar Power ride around the lake, Hylia? You will love it! Next up for the Fantastification, one big guy. Right, well, that's 20 rupees. Oh, we don't have 20 rupees. Darn it! I didn't realize we didn't have enough money. Okay, we're gonna go and get some money real quick then. There should be at least 3 rupees somewhere outside. We got a sword. We got grass everywhere. We got the power to get money. Because apparently this sword is magical and gives us money when we kill things and swing things. Of course, there's like nothing around. Here we go. Here's some grass. Come on, 3 rupees. 3 rupees. Can I get a 3 rupees? Anything. Please. Not a heart. I don't need a heart. Come on. I need 3 rupees. Maybe this crow will give me something. Yeah. Hey, there's another one. Maybe they'll give me money. What the heck? Where did that guy come from? I swear he wasn't there. Am I crazy? This guy looked like he just fell out of the sky. I'm not crazy, am I? It looked like he just fell out of the sky and then started running after me. Maybe I'm crazy, I don't know. Okay, we still haven't gotten 3 rupees. Isn't this fun? Oh my god. How much does it take to get 3 rupees? You know what? No, we got bombs, we got the ability. Let's just break this rock. Yeah! And to make it speed up, there we go. Jeez. Oh, that's actually really useful. Normally there's a bunch of rupees there and you have to go collect them all, but you could just use the boomerang and you get them all instantly. Okay, let's go ahead and go back, because now we can afford the Fobby's Flight Fantastification, or whatever it is. We get a nice view of Lake Hylia from up here. It's so nice. Okay, let's go ahead and get in here again. We're gonna fly a cuckoo. It's gonna be so much fun. Off key. Okay. So, let's talk to you, blah blah blah, we already heard what you said, let's buy it, alright, thanks, get the cuckoo, fly to the Island of Riches. So we're gonna pick up this one, dang it, we're gonna pick up this one, and here we go. So we're aiming for that thing right there. So we can go ahead and go along this trail just to make it a little bit more rewarding if we do miss. And as long as we get these last 2 rupees, we should have enough to do it once more if we need to. Okay. So here's the tough part. Landing on that middle one right there. Okay, here we go. I think I can do it. Yes. Yes! Whew. Did it. And on the top, we got a orange rupee! I forgot that's what it was. However, on the second one... No! No! That one's a heart piece! No! Oh man. The third one's a cuckoo stamp. The fourth one is a red rupee. Dang it! I was like, I'm gonna drop on. I got all of them. I was so happy. Ugh. I'm just gonna keep going and then, like, cut in the middle of that of me getting it. So go ahead and record that me for later. Okay, sorry if the camera angle sucks, but whatever. This is a bonus clip. It doesn't have to be that good. Okay, we're gonna get the heart piece on my spare time. You may notice I look different. Ignore that. Nothing's different. I'm not blue. I'm still green. You're just colorblind. Obviously. Okay. So we're gonna, one, get the treasure chest on the top, and two, get the heart piece on the second level. Because I want the money. I'm greedy. And... got it. Okay. So... after you beat it the first time and you try again to do it, the 100 rupees will respawn in the chest. So lucky that. Okay. This time, we can do it. Oh man. And drop. Yes! Alright, we got it. Another heart piece. There we go. So that's that. Bonus clip over. Yay! Alright, so we're gonna just go ahead and go back. So we're gonna go back to Hyrule Castle. It's kind of funny, because if you actually don't get any rewards, then you basically can't get back up. Unless you find some money somewhere. So we're back up here. We skipped the cutscene. And now we can go ahead and start heading to Hyrule Castle. Man, I can't believe I missed that. I was, like, so close. Alright. Enough sidetracking. Let's go. So I think we need to be going just straight forward, actually. And I think somewhere around here there is... yes! Some horse grass, or whatever they call it. To Kalipona. It's kind of fortunate that all of this little grass thing... can manage to call Epona from anywhere. Hi, Epona. We're not gonna... dang it. Oh, hi, Epona. Get on! There we go. I kept, like, wanting to get on the back to, like, go fast, but we were facing the opposite way, so it wouldn't have really helped us. Alright. Heading to the castle of Hyrule. And we get to hear the nice... peaceful ending music. And now I have to hear the creepy music that always freaked me out as a kid. It's all, like, creepy. I don't really know what a better way to explain it than that is. So, now that we're human, we can go ahead and talk to this wolf again! We get to learn a new skill! go through the same old routine where he's like, grr, and then he bites our head off. It's a good thing that only teleports us and doesn't actually it doesn't actually physically hurt us. Maybe mentally. We meet again. It appears your efforts have begun to return some vigor to Hyrule, but it's far too early to relax. Do you feel ready to earn another hidden skill to steel yourself for the forthcoming battles against more powerful foes? Very well. But before we begin, I must test you to ensure you have mastered the last skill I taught you, the shield attack. Now then, come at me. So we just have to attack him, and there we go. Haven't used that like at all. Excellent. Appears you are certainly capable of performing my lost art. Very well. My third hidden skill is the backslice. Let it be hewn into your mind. This one is awesome. I wish all of Zelda games had this just in it. Because this is like an awesome attack. A mere shield attack is no match for an enemy protected not just by a shield, but by a thick, full-body coat of armor. Such enemies are often focused on guarding against the frequent frontal attacks. They often leave their rear unprotected. This is when you blah blah blah, you do stuff, and you attack them from behind. This is the backslice. Now try it. I think the only other game that does this is Wind Waker. So you just spin around him and attack from behind. Awesome move, in my opinion. You carry yourself well, but do not forget the proper timing for swinging your sword while you jump. The third hand skill, the backslice, has been passed on. Why can't all the Zelda games have that attack? It's so awesome! So we learn the third hidden skill. There are still four hidden skills left for you to learn. We're almost halfway already. Do not neglect your daily sword training between now and the time you come to learn the next skill. May we meet again. Alright. Now we go directly to Hyrule Castle, which is just over here. Let's see if we can use this on an enemy real quick. Attack. Actually, we're just gonna do this. Wait, I wanna show something cool. I don't know if I can do it right, but let's try it. Okay. Dang it, okay. I got this. Yeah, you can attack the arrows with your sword. Who needs a shield? Okay, maybe I do. But whatever. So, okay, enough dilly-dallying, let's go. And if I remember correctly, Mr. Link! Wait! It's this guy again. Greetings, Mr. Link. I have come to deliver a letter. It's a letter for you, two letters in fact. I wish the mailman was this, like, businessy. He just, like, followed you, tracked you down. Actually, that'd be really creepy. So let's see what these two letters are about. I already saw that. The Lunaru Tourist Association has prepared a grand tour of natural splendor. Our current main attraction... I don't know what this is about. Okay, so there's just some stuff we can do now, which we will be doing before we go to the dungeon, I think. So there's going to be a little bit of side questing now, before we actually do the dungeon. So, but first, we should probably actually go see Leia and Rallus. And I think that's all the time we will have for. But first, let's go over to this guy and give him 50 rupees. Let's give him 100 rupees. Because I'm nice. Trust me, you want to give him a bunch of your rupees. It'll be useful for later on. So give him as many 50s as you can. Okay, so let's go and talk to them. The Leia, Rallus, people. We'll ignore everything else. I don't want to talk to you. Yeah, your fortune, good, whatever. I don't care. Here we are, back to the bar. Ha, that rhymed. Okay. Let's watch this play out. That is a Zora child. This is beyond my expertise. Did he just push me with his nose? Oh yeah, see ya. Doctor, wait. If something isn't done, this child will... It's Leia. And she sees us. Turned down. What's going on? She didn't even give us a second look. Well, this isn't good. A human doctor won't do, huh? This is pretty confusing for us. So, that's Telma. The old coot reminded me, though. I've heard of a shaman in Kakariko Village, in the Elden Lands, who's tended Gorons and Zoras. Is that true? Perhaps if we take him there. Inadvisable. Too dangerous. But we can't turn a blind eye to a pretty girl in need, either. Yes, we'd better escort you. Am I right, boys? Yeah! Wow! We're awesome! We're guards! We can fight things! We got spears! Well, isn't that nice? To reach Kakariko, we've got to cross two plains that are each infested with by dangerous beasts. What? But we'll be safe now. They're all gone. Cowards! Don't ever show your faces here again! Oh my. Looks like we've got one young swordsman left. I'm just like, wait, what's going on? Why is it Leia talking to me? And not only that, but it looks like this brave young man will escort us up. So let's get ready to go, honey. Pronto! So, Telma comes up to us and says, you know that girl, don't you? How did you know? It's a real shame. She can't even remember her own name right now. Bless her heart. She found this poor boy collapsed in the road, so she did all she could to save him. More courage in that girl than all in all the soldiers of Hyrule, for sure. You lend your strength to her, you hear me? Yes. We got a nice picture of the cat. Cat's important for later. That's called foreshadowing. So, we see the bridge just above Lake Hylia. It seems to have that one ogre guy that we killed that last time. He's back. Don't know how. So you say the bridge to the east has been destroyed, huh? Then our only option is to cross the bridge to the west. That's the one where the portal thing showed up and took cast a spell. So, yep, this guy is back. You see what that means? Yeah, how did that guy survive? You'll have to deal with that thing. Yeah, I already have, like, two other times. But he doesn't die. So, we were there for a second, and now all of a sudden we're here. That confused me, but it's kind of like a cutscene, I guess. They just didn't do a very good job at making that make sense. Thank you so much for this. If you don't mind me asking, what's your name? Ah, it's so dumb. So I say Link. Link? I will never in all my life forget your kindness, Link. Well, you kind of did. Little lady, I think you'd best save your thanks until we're safe in Kakariko. And here's the good part. The swordsman of ours has great eyes, honey. They're proud and wild. They're like a feral beast. That's funny because we turned into a wolf. We need a beast right now to keep the true ones at bay. If we make it to Kakariko safely, we'll just thank him then, okay? And then here we go. Oh man, she's hitting on us. We're like, whoa. We smile. Oh, that's funny. Okay, so we're escorting them to Kakariko Village. Here we go. So we're going to want to get out our arrows and our boomerang. These will be our most important items for this journey. But we will be doing that in the next episode because I didn't realize we were already this far in. See you guys then.